A very good morning to all the children of class 3 and welcome to your English literature class. After a week, we are joining back to the videos and we will be doing a very good and very interesting funny chapter, that is The Curious Baby Elephant. Before we move to the chapter, I would like to thank all of you for giving me the unit test papers, for writing your project so nicely. It's so beautiful. I have read all of your wishes and I loved each one of them and I wish that you fulfill them. Okay, and just a little bit of instruction, children, that is, when you write answers, you please leave one line in between the sentence. That is, you write in one line, you leave the next line and then you go to the third line while you write the answers, so that it is easy to read and it is clear and it is very neat. If you leave one line and write, the handwriting, the work presentation becomes neat. Okay, so see to it. I know it's very new to you this year because you change from four lines to single line and then again you copy the question numbers, everything you have to copy in your things, like in your answer sheet. I know this is tough, but still it's okay. If you practice, you will be able to do it. Okay, that's it. So today's lesson is The Curious Baby Elephant. So in this lesson, we will learn, we will see that how this baby elephant, this curious baby elephant, what happens to this baby elephant when he becomes very curious. First, this baby elephant never had a long trunk like elephant nowadays. It had a very small nose which he could move from left to right, and it was just the size of a boot. Now how this baby elephant's nose becomes tall and strong, we will see in this chapter. Okay, before that, we will finish this first. That is, look at these pictures and complete the sentences given below. So can you see, children, there are so many animals: elephants, zebra, turtle. This is tiger, bear, deer, fish. Okay, so leopard. This is leopard actually. So number one, an elephant has got a long, see, T is given, it's got a long trunk, T-R-U-N-K. This is the first page, children. This is the first page of the chapter, chapter number 3. This is the first page. I'll tell you the chapter number. This is page number 44. Okay, this is the first page of the chapter. So you will write here trunk, T-R-U-N-K. Number 2, a zebra has got stripes. It has got stripes, black stripe and white stripe. S-T-R-I-P-E-S. Okay, I will give you the answers today, but I will not write it for you. I want to see how many of you do it. A turtle has got a, what is this? You will find it out yourself. Okay, a leopard has got a, these two you will find it out yourself. A fish has got a dash and dash, fin and scales. This is two words, that is why I've gave you. A fish has got fins, F-I-N-S, fins, and scales, S-C-A-L-E-S. Can you scan? How many of you have seen the scales of fish? We all have seen. We eat fish and we can see that in our home. A deer got a antelope. Okay, spelling I will not give you. You will do it yourself. A bear has fur, F-U-R. So what are the homework? Number three, turtle has got a dash. A leopard has got dash. And the deer has got antelope, and you will get the spelling of this antelope. These are antelopes. These are horns. Okay. So you will get the spelling. You will do number 6, and you will give me number 3 and 4 in the next video. Okay. I want you all to see whether you can do it or not. Okay. There are a little bit of information about the elephant or elephant's trunk. See, an elephant's trunk has up to 150,000 muscles in it. Oh my God. Okay. It uses it to pick up objects, trumpet warnings, and to greet others. Elephant use this trunk to pet and caresses those they love in times of discomfort or stress. So if you are sad and you have an elephant, the elephant will love you, will care you, caresses you, or will hug you with that trunk. Okay. So it's like a whole lot of emotion in the trunk that elephant has. Now we will find out something about the author Rudyard Kipling. He is a very famous author and writer. He is an English journalist, short story writer, poet, novelist, and was born in Bombay, India. Much of his work was inspired by his life in India. His most famous works are The Jungle Book. We all have seen Jungle Book and we all love Simba, right? Yes. The Man Who Would Be King and Kim. So these are the two famous work of Balu, Bagheera. We all know them from Jungle Book, right? Yes. So this author Rudyard Kipling was a very famous author for children. He wrote English short story, he wrote poems, he wrote novels also. He was born in Bombay and he was inspired by his life in India. He wrote about what he saw, he wrote about what he felt, and this feeling was inspired by his life and where he lived, that is in India. Okay. And the two most famous books are Jungle Book and The Man Who Would Be King and Kim. So your homework will be to find out a little more about the author Rudyard Kipling. Okay. That's all for today, children. We will start with the chapter, or we will start with the story in the next video, where we will find out that how was the baby elephant, how much curious was the baby elephant, and what happened to that trunk. It's a mystery. Okay. So that's all for today, children. We'll meet in the next video. Okay. Have a nice day.